Hello friends, welcome to Jashan Education. Now let us go to the video. In this video, let us explore about class 10 science life processes. Part 1, autotrophic nutrition. Nutrition. Food is the essential source of energy for all living organisms. Organisms need food to obtain energy in order to stay alive and perform life process. Do you know what is nutrition? The process of taking in food by an organism and utilization for the body of an organism is called as nutrition. The two modes of nutrition based on the ways organism obtain food are called as autotrophic nutrition and heterotrophic nutrition. In this video, let us learn about autotrophic nutrition. Autotrophs. In the word autotrophs, auto means self, trophs means nourishment. The organisms that make their own food are called as autotrophs. Autotrophs use inorganic sources in the form of CO2 and H2O, that is carbon dioxide and water. And the example of autotrophs are green plants and some bacteria. Autotrophic nutrition. The nutrition in which an organism makes its own food is called as autotrophic nutrition. The organisms that follow autotrophic nutrition are called as autotrophs. Autotrophic plants are able to produce food. They are also called as producers. Depending upon the source of energy used in the preparation of food, autotrophic nutrition is divided into two types. They are photosynthetic nutrition and chemosynthetic nutrition. Now let us learn about photosynthetic nutrition. This mode of nutrition occurs in green plants. Organisms make their own food through the process of photosynthesis. The organisms that follow photosynthetic nutrition are called as photoautotrophs. Photoautotrophs take in H2O and CO2, that is water and carbon dioxide, in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll to produce carbohydrate. Carbohydrates are utilized for providing energy to the plants. And excess carbohydrates is being stored in the form of starch. Let us learn the equation for photosynthesis. That is carbon dioxide plus water in the presence of chlorophyll and sunlight gives rise to glucose plus oxygen and water. Now let us learn the chemical formula for photosynthesis. That is 6CO2 plus 12H2O in the presence of chlorophyll and sunlight gives rise to C6H12O6 plus 6O2 plus 6H2O. Let us learn the steps involved in photosynthesis. They are absorption of light energy by chlorophyll. Light energy is converted into chemical energy. And water molecules are converted into hydrogen and oxygen. Carbon dioxide is reduced into carbohydrates. But these steps need not take place one after the other immediately. For example, in desert plants, they take in CO2, that is carbon dioxide, at night and prepare an intermediate product. And this intermediate product act upon the energy absorbed by the chlorophyll during the day. Now let us learn how the materials required for photosynthesis is received. For that, let us see the cross section of the leaf under the microscope. While seeing the cross section of the leaf under the microscope, we can see some cells containing green dots. These green dots are cell organelles. They are called as chloroplast. and the chloroplast contain chlorophyll. Chlorophyll helps to trap the sunlight, and the chloroplast is more in upper epidermis, so that they are able to trap more sunlight, and that is why the upper layer of the leaf is dark in color, and the first layer of leaf is upper epidermis, and upper epidermis is covered with waxy cutilage, and the lower layer of leaf is lower epidermis, and lower epidermis has tiny openings in its surface, and these tiny openings are called as stomata, and stomata is enclosed by guard cells. Now let us study how the plants obtain carbon dioxide. Plants take in CO2 or carbon dioxide from the surrounding, that is atmosphere, through the tiny pores present in the leaf surface, and these tiny pores are called as stomata. Singular of stomata is stoma. The stomata surrounded by the special type of cells are called as guard cells. These guard cells regulate opening and closing function of the stomata. Large amount of water can also be lost during this stomata. So, guard cell closes the stomata when it does not need CO2, that is carbon dioxide, for photosynthesis. During photosynthesis, gaseous exchange occurs through the surface of stems, roots and leaves. But massive or large amount of gaseous exchange take place in the leaves through the stomata. And when water flows in these guard cells swell, and which opens the stomata. And now CO2 is able to get into the plant. And when water moves out of the cell, the guard cell shrinks and closes the stomata. Now let us learn how is water absorbed for photosynthesis. Water is also used in photosynthesis. Plants absorb water from the soil through their root system. Water and minerals are absorbed by the root hair present near the end of the roots. The water absorbed is transported through the leaves with the help of xylem vessels. Let us learn about the second type of autotrophic nutrition, that is chemosynthetic nutrition. Some organisms that make their own food through the process of chemosynthesis. The organisms that follow chemosynthesis to produce food are called as chemoautotrophs. Chemoautotrophs make use of chemical energy released during oxidation of simple organic compounds to make their food. And the example of chemosynthetic nutrition are Nitrosomonas bacteria, iron bacteria, sulfur bacteria, etc. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, like and share, and do not forget to subscribe my channel.